Vidure College, Grade 3, English. Hello, my dear children. How are you? Today, we are going to learn English literature. Okay, children. Today, we will learn Black Beauty by Anna Sewell, Chapter 1 and 2. The Black Beauty is a fictional autobiography of a talking horse. What is an autobiography? Autobiography is a book that tells the life story of the writer. The story we are learning today tells us the life story of Black Beauty. This book was published in 1877. It was written by Anna Sewell and it remains a favorite children's book to this day. The novel deals with the well-being of animals and gives the lesson in kindness, sympathy and the respect for others. Okay children, let's see what we are going to learn today. In this presentation, you will learn about the Black Beauty book chapter 1 and 2. You will learn about the major events and some of the main characters. And also end of each chapter, your knowledge will be tested. When we talk about the characters of the Black Beauty story, there are 33 characters. Some of them are Black Beauty, Ginger, Farmer Gray, Squire Gordon, Duchess, John Manley, Mrs. Gordon and so on. Children, Black Beauty is the main character of this story. Black Beauty begins by describing his earliest memories as a young horse with his mother. Black Beauty begins by describing his earliest memories. He fondly remembers the pleasant meadow and few trees in it. He was under the care of his mother. The beauty said, "I don't remember everything about the time I was small. I remember a big field of green grass. There were few trees in it. And on hot days, my mother stood under a tree and I drank her milk. That was before I grew bigger and began to eat grass. There were six young colts in the meadow with the beauty. They were older than Beauty. Beauty used to run with them and play. So he had a great fun. They used to gallop all together, round and round. You know what is galloping? Yes, galloping means very quick run. When he was young, he lived upon his mother's milk. In the daytime, he played with other young horses, and at night, he lay down close to his mother. As soon as Beauty was old enough to eat grass, his mother started her work in the daytime and came back in the evening. When she came back, Beauty told all his day, like yours. One day, Beauty's mother calls him and gave him a lifelong advice. I wish you could listen very carefully. I'm glad you are happy. Play as much as you can. But you must remember that you are not like these other young horses. They are all going to be farm horses. They are good horses, but not like us. You have been well born. Your father has a great name in the country. Your grandfather, that means my father, was Lord Whistler's best horse. He won the medals. When you are little older, you will learn to take people on your back or take them from place to place in their carriages. Beauty's mom gives him a major life lesson, which he never forgets. Beauty asks, "Is that what your work is, Mother? Is that what you do for Farmer Gray?" Mother said, "Yes, that's what I do. Farmer Gray sometimes rides me and sometimes drives me as his carriage horse." Beauty's mother's name was Duchess. Farmer Gray came into the field. Farmer Gray was good, kind man. He gave them good food. He spoke very kindly to them, like father speak to his little children. Beauty's mother, Duchess, loved him very much. He gave her something nice to eat and asked, "How is your little son?" He patted Beauty and gave him some bread, which was very nice. Beauty thinks he and his mom might be their master's favorites. Mother advised Beauty, "You must learn to please him. Always do your work gladly and never bite or kick. Then he will always be nice to you." Children, read the first chapter of the Black Beauty book and answer the following questions. Question number 1. Who is telling the story of his life? Question number 2. What is the advice given by his mother? Okay, children, let's check your answers. The question number 1. Who is telling the story of his life? Black Beauty tells the story of his life. The question number 2. What is the advice given by his mother? His mother gave him lifelong advice. Be gentle and good in all things. Work with good spirit and do not ever kick or bite. Okay, children, let's move to chapter 2, learning. When Black Beauty was 4 years, he was very handsome. His coat began to look very good and he had one white foot. A white star on his face and a small white mark on his back and other parts were black. One day, Farmer Gray brought another man to see Black Beauty. His name was Squire Gordon. He looked at his eyes. He examined his mouth, legs and said, "Now he must learn to work. He will be very good horse then." Next day, Beauty began his training. He must learn to stand still when man put harness on him. The back part of the horse harness is the bit. There was a piece of metal attached to the leather straps which is put into his mouth. You can see in the picture. It hurts Beauty and have a strange feeling. Those who have never had a bit in their mouth cannot think how bad it feels. It is very bad. He was very unhappy. But Farmer Gray used kind words, gently ways, some food to convince him. Beauty thought, "My mother always wore bit when she went out, and all other horses did when they were grown up." Next, Farmer Gray fixed a saddle on Beauty's back. A horse must learn to have a saddle and to take a man, woman or child on his back. He must go where the rider wants him to go. He must go fast or slow, just as his driver wishes. Farmer Gray walked with the horse on the big field. After that, Farmer Gray patted him and gave him lots of kind words and good food. Beauty liked the food and the patting and kind words. After some time, he wasn't afraid of the bit and the saddle. One morning, Farmer Gray got onto his back and rode him round the meadow on the soft grass. Beauty was glad to carry his kind master on his back. He continued to ride him every day. The next unpleasant thing was putting some iron shoes. That too was very hard at first time. The man took Beauty's feet and cut away some of the hoof. It doesn't pain him. Then put some iron shoe. Beauty said, "My feet felt very stiff and heavy, but in time I got used to it." They saved Beauty's feet from hard roads and stones. Next, he learned to go in carriage harness. There was a stiff, heavy collar and blinkers at the side of face. With blinkers, beauty cannot see either side, only he can see straight. So in time he used to everything. Farmer Gray then took Beauty and his mother to pull a carriage. He expected him to learn a lot from his mother. I did learn a lot. She showed me how to move and how to know what the driver wanted, and there are good drivers and bad drivers, good masters and bad masters. Farmer Gray is a good master. He's a kind and he thinks about his horses. So you must always be good and try to make people love you. And also she told me, better I behave, the better I should treat it. Never be lazy, even if people are unkind to you or foolish. So my dear children, from this lesson, I hope you also get some of the good qualities to your life. Never be lazy, always be good and try to make people love you, and always be kind to others. Okay children, now it's time to read the second chapter of the Black Beauty book and write the answers for the given two questions. What made the horse unhappy? The second question, what did Beauty learn from his mother? Okay children, let's see whether your answers are correct. The first question, what made the horse unhappy? He was unhappy with the bit in his mouth. The second question, what did Beauty learn from his mother? Learn to pull a carriage with his mother, learn to move, and how to know what the driver wanted. My dear children, I know you are eagerly waiting to know what has happened to Black Beauty next. I will meet you another day with another chapters of the Black Beauty book. Until that, stay safe. Bye.